Hello students, now today we are going to study about the set relations. In previous video I have talked to you about the set, that definition. Okay, the part describing the set, third one, that what is cardinal number of set, and finally the types of set. Now today in this video we are going to discuss about the set relation. That means if we compare two or more than two sets, then from that also we can find the different types of sets. Okay, so what are the types of the sets on the basis of the set relation? That means if we compare two or more than two sets, then what are the types of sets? So here set relation, that means here types of set on the basis of the elements contained by the two or more than two sets. Okay, we can also say that the comparison, that means if we compare two or more than two sets, then from that also we can find the different relation, that means different types of sets that can be also formed. So what are the different types of sets? Today we are going to discuss on that. Okay, so here first one, that is overlapping. Now this overlapping set, that means what? Here if we compare two or more than two sets, and in that given sets if we find some common elements, at least one common element, then such type of set is said to be overlapping. Okay, so here two or more than two sets are said to be overlapping set if they contain at least one common elements. If we compare two or more than two sets, and in the given that sets if we find that if they have at least one common element, then we can say that is overlapping set. Suppose here example, a set A has the elements A, E, I, O, U, and set B has the elements E, F, G, H. Here the two sets are A and B. Set A has the elements A, E, I, O, U, and similarly set B has the elements E, F, G, H. Okay, so if we compare, if we see that both the elements of the sets, then we find that some elements of the this given sets, they are common to each other. That means here this E and here also E, we find that this E is common to both the sets. In set A also we find the elements E, in set B also we find the elements E, so we can say that it is a overlapping set. So we can say that A and B sets are overlapping set. Here these elements that are overlapping to each other, so we can say that it is overlapping set. Similarly, if we consider another example, suppose here W equals 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and n equals 3, 4, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Suppose that the set W, it has the elements 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And set N, that has the elements 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Then if we can compare both these elements, then we find that some elements of these two sets that are common to each other. That means in W also, in set W and in set M, in both sets we find some common elements. What are the common elements? That means here this 3, here also 3, 4, 4, 5, 5. So here we find the common elements, that is 3. Here 3 elements are common to these sets. So we can say that this W and M both are overlapping sets. Okay, now disjoint set. Second one, disjoint set. Now this disjoint set, that is a two or more than two sets, that can be said as disjoint set if they don't have any common elements. If we don't find any common elements, then such type of sets are said to be disjoint set. Two or more than two sets are said to be disjoint set if they have no any common elements, then it is said to be disjoint. Okay, I have written here two or more than two sets are said to be disjoint set if they have no any common elements. Okay, leave it. I have already written here. So if we compare two or more than two sets and if we don't find any common elements, then that is said to be disjoint set. Suppose example here. Okay, X, that has the elements 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Y has the elements 6, 7, 8, 9. We are given the two sets having the elements, that set X has the elements 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and set Y has the elements 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay, then here we find that no any common elements in both sets. It has the different elements, and similarly set Y, it has also the different elements. They have no any common elements. Then we can say that these are the disjoint set. Okay, here these elements are totally different to this one. So this is disjoint set. Now third one, that is equal set. Now equal set means what? Here if we compare two or more than two sets and if we find that they have the exactly same elements, then we can say that that is equal set. That means here two or more than two sets are said to be equal set if they have exactly the same elements. Here two or more than two sets are said to be equal set if they have exactly the same elements. That means here if we consider an example, suppose C, it has the elements 1, 3, 5, 7. D, 1, 3, 5, 7. Here two sets are given, that is set C and set D. And set C has the elements 1, 3, 5, 7. Similarly, set D 1, 3, 5, 7. Here we find that they have the same number of elements. How many elements are here? 1, 2, 3, 4. Here also 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay? There they have the same number of elements. And we find that they have the same elements also. Here 1, here also we find 1. 3, here also 3. 5, here also 5. 7, here also 7. It means that we can say that it is equal. They have the exactly the same elements. So we can say that these two sets that are equal set. Okay, so we can write this C equals D. That means set C is equal to set D. Similarly, another example, suppose here M equals A, B, C, D, and N equals C, D, A, B. Look at here. Here we are given the two sets, set M and set N. Here set M has the elements A, B, C, D, and set N has the elements C, D, A, B. Here we find that they have the same number of elements, and we see here that they have also the exactly same elements also. Their positions are only interchanged, so we should not consider about the position. Okay, we just have to consider the elements, whether they have the exactly same elements or not. If they have the exactly same elements, then we can simply say that is equal set. So here this A, here we find A, here also we find A. B, here also we find B. C, here also we find C. D, here also we find D. So we can say that this M set and this N set, that are equal set. So M equals N. M set is equal to N set. Okay. Okay, now fourth one, that is equivalent set. Equivalent set. Okay. So here this equivalent set means here. Again, here also if we compare two or more than two sets, and if we find that they have the same cardinal number, same number of elements, then we can say that is the equivalent set. Here two or more than two sets are said to be equivalent set if they have same number of elements. Here this same number of elements, that means they should have the same cardinal number. If their cardinal numbers are same, then we can say that is equivalent set. Here two or more than two sets, they can be said as equivalent set if they have the same cardinal number, or in other words we can say that if they have the same number of elements, then we can say it as equivalent set. Example here, suppose E set has the elements A, B, C, D, and F set has the elements P, Q, R, S. Here two sets, set E and set F. Set E has the elements A, B, C, D, and set F has the elements P, Q, R, S. Okay, so how many elements are here? 1, 2, 3, 4. It means the cardinal number of set E is 4. Similarly, how many elements are there in set F? 1, 2, 3, 4. Here also we find the 4 elements. It means that the cardinal number of set F, that is also 4, and the cardinal number of set E, that is also 4. They have the same cardinal number. So we can say that this E set is equivalent to F set. Okay, so we can say that this E and F, they are equivalent set. So we can write this as E set equivalent to F set. This is the symbol for equivalent. Okay, this is the symbol for equivalent. So we can write it as E set, set E is equivalent to set F. In this way, we have finished the this set relation about that types of sets on the basis of the elements contained by the given sets. Okay, so for this video we have discussed up to here. Okay, and in further in our next video we shall discuss about the subset, proper subset, improper subset. Okay, so till then, okay, thank you class.